go the hard way, and that's a lesson, baby. Make these niggas take me all day. That's my profession, baby. I've been going up and all day.
What else? Spin a track.
I'm gonna take this shit way far away, cause I've been messing with it.
Yo. Just tuning into the Goodfellas podcast, episode 26.
26, that can't go fast.
Very special episode. We got some special people in the building. Shouts out to GLO. GLO gang.
No, Lady GLO. Let's not forget.
She just told you 2 minutes ago. What's she?
Don't care.
Oh,
don't
wow.
be disrespectful to our guests, bro.
That's crazy. You see him? No manners. Right? Tell Faith.
Chill out.
OD telling Faith.
But yeah, shouts out to them and Defeat the Norm podcast. The rest of the hosts in the building. Shouts out to Maul.
Couch Boy Maul.
Shouts out to
1UP. DJ 1UP.
This
is
Jigga. Rob.
So what's good, y'all? How y'all feeling?
Tired.
Dehydrated.
Last
tired.
Night.
Yeah.
Last night we got sauced.
Sauce.
I didn't do my little intro. All right. This
Go
is
ahead.
Lady GLO on the mic from Defeat the Norm podcast. Okay.
Talk your shit.
All right. Keep going.
Go crazy. Go ahead. Talk your shit. Let them know who you are.
All right. How was your weekend?
It was cool.
Yeah.
It was cool. A lot of drinking.
My weekend was lit per usual. You know, it's my birthday.
Happy belated.
Yeah. I went to Atlanta.
How you turn 19?
Briefly, 26. What? Unfortunately. I wish I was still 21, but it's all good. I'm still lit. I'm still in my prime, you know.
I hear that.
That's a fact.
But yeah, last night, bro, I was done up.
Yeah, last done night. It was like right at that edge. You on the edge where you take one more sip, it's over for you. I was like flirting with that shit.
What was last night?
One of our boys, Guy, and he had like a little, he called the party shenanigans.
Oh,
it was definitely some shit.
It was, But we was in there cutting up, though. A lot of Henny.
A lot of jokes.
A lot of jokes. A lot of douce.
A lot of hookah. And the food was fire. Yeah. Shout out to the cooks. Yeah,
I love food.
They had like vegan food, regular food, everything.
Yeah, that Beyond Meat shit is really fire.
Yo, and the little
you ever had it?
Peppers with quinoa shit. Mm. That shit was busting. Nah.
Oh, yeah, that shit was busting.
Nah, that was my first time having it either.
I'm in there.
I was cool. Killing that shit. Yeah, you was sauce.
That mezcal was kicking your ass.
I was good until you started putting Henny and Deuce
in
my cup.
We was good on a tequila roll, and then this dumbass comes in here with fucking Deuce. Here, take a shot. Our dumbass is what we do.
But I mean, Deuce like, to the you, head. I mean, that's just me. If I'm around my niggas, we all about to just die.
Shut up.
We all about to just. Yo, it's like killing your friends.
Shut up. I kept telling us I had work this morning.
So what the fuck that be?
But like talk he was trying to line us and then lie himself.
So,
and he'd
okay.
be the only one like on
the
floor.
I think you went to ATL for your birthday, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when you went down, you ain't had that friend that just be like, all right, fuck it. You got a drink.
Talking to the mic, nigga.
That's a trip though.
Sorry.
Talking to the mic.
Huh?
That's a trip.
You know, but listen.
It don't matter.
If you going out, then nigga, you already know what's up.
Yes. You already know the vibes.
I didn't know I got right in the morning. I don't stay jazz home.
I tried. I'm like, I might take a nap. Nah, stay your ass up. We out.
Cause no, you like you to take naps and not wake up till the next day. Like, so we wasn't having
I'm like, yo, all right, we out at 8:30. Why are you trying to take a nap at 7:45?
Because I just got home from work.
So what?
That shit does not matter.
You should have muted them niggas. That's it.
So wow, are you that? Time. Are you what? Are you that friend?
Yes, I am. Period.
Oh damn.
Yeah. Period.
Wow. Applying the fresh air. I would not be nah.
Listen, I would come up with every fucking excuse. Oh, my grandmother died.
Let's drink.
Oh,
wow.
I'm not going out. Yeah. So that is me. Okay. So.
Well then.
R.I.P. Grandma.
I have damn. No damn. Shame.
Granny loved Henny.
No shame whatsoever. I gotta get mine by all means.
What'd you do last night? Oh, okay.
Yeah. Went to some fucking lame ass friends.
Friendsgiving?
Pretty much.
Friendsgiving.
I slept the entire time.
You slept at the function?
Yes. Granted, I was high, but it was just like. Yeah.
Could definitely not be ours.
Definitely not be one of ours.
Next time, invite me, okay?
Hey, we got you.
Got you. How many parties you been to? Like twice? Like two?
What, one of y'all's?
Yeah.
Maybe two.
He was at Henny Day.
Henny Day. That shit
the
was
the first
good.
Henny day or the last
it was
last
good.
Was
no, the second,
so
she said the second one.
It was good.
Yeah. She said it. I was like, yo, yeah, out here.
Man, it was good.
Wow. That was a wild ass night.
Regular vibes.
Wait, hold up.
Regular vibes.
Okay. Regular vibes.
Lady Glow. I'm sorry.
Lady Glow.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
You said it was good. It was great.
Oh, I should say that.
I'm saying it for you.
You don't have to. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, I mean, it was lit. I was pleasantly surprised.
That's what I like.
No, only because, like, you know, I'm not too familiar with, you know, the whole movement and all that. Like, okay. The crowd that you guys pull out. Mm-hmm. But that crowd.
Yeah, they was in there. They was in there. They definitely was in there. They was definitely in there.
For real.
What a time.
Nigga was mad when that shit shut down. Like, so.
Yeah, that was wild. The owner came was like, man, at least we got 15 minutes.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
he came to the DJ booth.
I was like, yeah, because I was right next to you. And he was like,
he said, y'all got till 8:30.
I was like, nah, 30 more minutes. He's like, 15. I'm like, 30? Huh? 30? I was like, all right, fuck
it. But aside from that, how's y'all this week, though? Aside from the weekend.
My week.
I feel like it's been a very eventful week.
Has it?
A lot of funny shit has happened this week.
Like what?
That Jawn Wick shit.
Oh, that Jawn Wick shit had me crying. Niggas had the picture of fucking Keanu.
How did that shit
whole start?
Like, why was he jumping at the cops?
I have no idea, bro.
Yeah, I wonder how, like, the whole shootout happened. So, those that never... That's not familiar with the whole Philly shooting. Nigga had a shootout with the cops.
Oh, Lord. Yeah, we shot like six cops, something like that.
Yeah, and they called son Jawn.
Jawn Wick.
Jawn Wick. And they put the koofy on, son.
Yo, Philly Twitter was really funny as hell.
But.
Niggas don't take shit serious.
Nigga said he wish nigga killed somebody, killed one of the cops. Y'all niggas is out of pocket.
Yo,
so
that's
wild.
I ain't wishing death on nobody. But.
Really?
I'm not. I ain't gonna say that because you never know. He might actually kill a cop that was actually, you know, actually a valid, solid cop for me.
Oh, you one of those, huh?
Nah, I'm not. But I'm just saying.
He fucking all that matters. Okay, like.
Oh no, nah, definitely fuck the cops. But I'm just saying, like.
Oh Lord.
Yeah. Oh,
since
Lord.
We on that, since we on that, quick little. Since we on that, you know how like.
Move your hand, dumbass.
What?
Are you coming so crazy?
I can't see you.
He's looking right at me.
Oh, your hand was in front of your face.
Anyway,
but like say different like altercations y'all had with cops.
Mm-hmm.
So like when y'all was growing up, oh, okay, how can I say this? When y'all was younger, were y'all like afraid of cops when y'all was younger?
When I was younger, I stayed away.
Yeah, this shit wasn't like being afraid. It was just stay out of their way. More so.
Did you grow up in the suburbs or?
No, I grew up in North.
Okay. Did you grow up in the suburbs or? East Orange, all right.
East Orange.
Okay, so for us, motherfuckers, we grew up in the suburbs, we weren't afraid of cops, you know?
Because the
cops, one, like, you know, the main niggas, they were in our schools, you know, hey, GLO, they knew our names and stuff, you know? So so we weren't, like, afraid of cops, so to speak, until maybe, like...
You got older?
Yeah, 3 years ago, maybe 4 years ago, where we saw what, you know, what really is up. You know what's really is up. And... Still now, like, I know cops who are, like, my friends who, you know, from my town, West Orange and stuff, you know, they'll tell me what's going on and stuff. So, to this day, I'm not really scared of cops. Whenever I'm in West Orange, if I do get stopped, they're not giving me a ticket.
Because you know them. Because you know them.
Not even if I know them. They just know that I live around the corner. So, it's like, they're one of us. You know what I'm saying? So, it's, like, it's different.
Yeah.
As opposed to...
I get pulled over West Orange.
Shot.
Are they mean to you though?
Hell yeah, man.
Really?
You know how many times we got pulled over?
Yeah, Glenridge, Montclair.
Glenridge.
Wait, so West Orange thought they fuck with y'all?
Hell yeah. West Orange cops used to fuck with me. Glenridge especially. I don't even know. I used to go around
Glenridge. The reason why I brought that up, because like today I was in Montclair, whatever. Mm-hmm. I went to Raymond's. And I seen like this cop. He was being mad for, like, I guess like this lady, her family was walking through. And like he was giving high fives to like the little white kids or whatever. So I'm like, if you go down the street to like Mission Street, them little kids is not walking up to him, giving him no high five. Like they looking at him some type of way, like, yeah, you locked up my father or some shit, like my uncle, so now I can't really trust you like that, you feel me? So it just made me think of that, like how like it starts of like people saying like,
but like,
yeah,
you
want to
know what's crazy too?
Like
I used to always tell niggas I felt safer in the hood than being in the birds. I used to go in the birds and we'd be walking around like Montclair or whatever and we see cops, I'll feel way different than
they not,
me being a Newark and a cop rob
off. They worry about like wild shit. Like, they're not about to fuck with niggas
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, New York cops really don't. Unless, like, something major happened, they really don't fuck. They got other shit to worry about. But cops in, like, Glenridge and all that shit. They be on some bullshit. I'll
say that. See, I can't say that because y'all had different addresses, but I've known people in West Orange where we literally was like smoke boxing, you know, in a car, and a cop would like literally pull up on us and like, "Yo, bro, you need to like go home." It's West Orange cops.
Yeah.
Maybe because we lived in West Orange, it was like you know.
Yeah, also, I got bad luck with police.
Yeah, I can't.
You think it's not, but
yeah. Especially New York cops. Remember how many times we got jammed up?
New York cops are different.
Way different.
I'll tell one of the New York stories. So we was going out one time.
Oh yeah.
I go across the street to get some pizza. I come back. These niggas on the hood of my car. I'm like, the fuck going
like
on?
They on the hood?
Parked in front of the club.
I think it was you and Cody.
Me, Cody, and Ree, I think.
And I'm walking back with the pizza. I'm like, stay right there. I'm like, it's my car. They're like, sit your ass on the curb. I'm like, fuck, so good.
What? They lit up. Trying to give us pizza and shit.
They tossed my put my car inside out. Juice spilling all in my shit.
Yeah, they knocked like, over the Henny, everything, going through the car, trying to find a strap. Like.
So with that glow, okay, like, damn. I know probably in your future, you probably wish to have kids or whatever.
Of course.
So when you have kids, and like, say you have a son, how are you gonna be prepared to like teach him about dealing with like law enforcement?
Oh, for sure. I'm gonna tell him like, you know, listen, when a cop pulls you over, make sure you got the registration, your license in your hand. That way you don't gotta reach over for the, you know, the glove box. Cause you have that little time frame between,
I never get pulled over by surprise.
Exactly, like you know what's up. You can definitely grab it real quick and like, right, whatever. But don't be on some like, you know, hostile shit where it's like, yo, why you pulling me over? Like, no, you're not white. You don't have that little privilege to say, why you pulling me over? No.
What makes that funny? Y'all see the video of the white lady like, you can't do this.
Oh, yo, what you got tased?
Yeah, you got tased.
Nigga chased her down and everything.
Fire.
Sign.
What are you doing? I'm not kidding. Zapped her dumbass. I swear to God, I was happy as hell.
She was still trying to find her. Yo, she peeled off and everything. Boy jumped in her shit, chased her down.
Like, what's scared to me? Like, we'll be on that now.
Called Chase. But yeah, that's definitely facts. Like, definitely, like, that was probably. Like,
but we all know if she was black, like, it would have been over. If she was pregnant, it wouldn't have mattered. All of that. Like, if she was black, like, it would have been over. Like, because they don't be caring about.
Don't get me wrong.
I had a few cops that gave me passes every now and then. It's red, but I got a couple passes.
Especially where, like, now, you know, like, we older, we see friends that like, we went to high school with, and now they cops.
Yeah.
Exactly. So you know what I'm saying?
But it usually be, like, the weirdo. Yeah, the weirdo niggas. Exactly. And that's why cops be acting like that.
Yeah, you done up.
It be those type of niggas that be cops. And then when they become cops, they be, like, be feeling that false sense of power they got. And they just act mad crazy, son. That's what it is. That should be annoying as hell.
That shit is.
But lucky they be mad cool, but once they get to that little uniform, it's like, oh nah. Like,
tripping.
I remember some corny nigga from high school gave me a ticket and fucking look.
Ah, shoot this bitch up.
Nigga chased my car on foot, called me at the red light, was like, yeah, pull over. I'm like, kid, you're bugging. You think I'm about to pull over, you on foot? Oh, come on, sir. Stop playing with me.
Oh, the free Meek.
With the Meek?
I didn't get a chance to watch that.
Yeah, I gotta watch that.
The joint on Amazon.
Yeah.
I was on Amazon?
Yeah, that's why I ain't watch it yet.
This ain't on Netflix.
That's what I'm saying. He should do like on Netflix, at least HBO. Netflix.
Sorry,
I'm like,
gonna find a link. I'm sorry, Meek. We about to free stream that.
Actually,
where's the Rock Nation promo? What are you talking about?
Like, Rock Nation promo.
Yeah, because you know he signed to Rock Nation. So why are we not super informed on this?
We knew that.
I've been saying
not like that.
Now we talked about it last week, right?
Okay, yeah, but the masses don't know that's on Amazon.
Oh yeah, people just don't know what.
I thought she was on Netflix. I just assumed she was on Netflix.
See, you thought it was on Netflix,
I had figured Beyonce shit was on Netflix. I figured they was gonna throw it on there too.
No.
I mean, I'm still not paying to watch it.
They really go extra hard for promo or anything.
Yeah, but he should have though.
Who?
But that's not
who, me.
No, Rock Nation.
Rock Nation, yeah.
Really
Rock Nation got
to type
in.
They just about like, they just dropped.
See, and that's the problem with us, because we make excuses for our own black-owned businesses. Like, no.
I got a question. Do Beyonce do promo?
Hell she no. don't eat
she
to.
Just dropped.
She but don't eat to. But if you, Meek Mill's is not Beyonce. So let's
nah,
let's
do
that.
Nah, he had promo. He had trailers and all that shit. Yeah. All over yeah, everybody
he
know
did,
about
he did.
It.
Listen, no. He did. He had a couple trailers for that, like, that one little weekend when
nah,
he was about to
I
drop.
I seen mad people
no.
repost it,
but do you
though.
Know about it?
You knew about it. We all knew
about
it.
I forgot about it. That's
you
a problem.
You didn't forget about it.
Yes, I did.
Wow. I forget about
until you guys mentioned
I forget about
it.
Shit
you
that happened
about
Friday.
It. Yeah, until you guys mentioned that.
Did,
yeah.
Brother. Oh, my, brother.
All right, so, but you knew about it. So the promo did his
no.
job. Yes.
No.
Promos did his job.
You ain't got to touch on
Let me tell you this. I'm more so looking forward to Rihanna's new album than the Meek Mill shit that's already coming out.
Rihanna is not dropping new
shit. Oh, yeah, but you got to think about it. People's not trying to watch.
The Navy.
We gonna be waiting for Rihanna.
Yeah, she in the
mix.
She over there swimming.
But people, you gotta understand. Some people not gonna want to watch that Meek Mill documentary yeah. just
no.
because it may be like wild, like depressing and shit.
Not
like
no, because we watched When This Is Us.
I didn't watch it.
I watched it 30 times already.
I didn't watch it 30 times.
Hey,
what was that again?
I watched it twice.
The shit about Central Park.
The Jordan Pill movie?
Central Park. Oh,
I was not putting myself through that
really?
That many times.
I watched it at least 10 times
that's,
already.
And I'm talking about
I
like,
seen it once. That was enough.
Back since we were just talking about things with the cops. That's why I'm like, I know certain things that I've been through, cop altercations and stuff like that. So I just didn't really want to watch it. Like, I ain't really want to be upset or whatever.
I watched it because everybody was talking about
it. Same like the Free Meek.
No.
It did its job. It got the people that really wanted to watch it.
No, because I didn't hear shit about that.
But you did hear shit
no.
about it because you knew about
not.
It.
Because
it's on Amazon.
Shit, so no.
Matter James fact, has a bro, point, though. I have
no.
problems. I'm getting my password is, to watch it.
Listen,
people don't got
problems
like that.
So like, basically,
hold on. He didn't do a little Breakfast Club interview.
What does
but,
that?
But here's the thing. Meek's agenda, as far as the Breakfast Club, he's not going to go up there to promote like a documentary.
He would. Are you kidding me?
When he came out, when he came out, the first thing he did was, yeah, I got this album on the way. Because he's a rapper. It's innate in him at this point. Maybe it was like in the back of his mind, but like at the end of the day,
I don't think it was like
it's gonna reach.
Priority.
It's gonna
like,
reach the
yeah,
people
telling his story.
Who's supposed to see it, you know what I'm saying?
The
and that's what James
to reach their sources, they're gonna promote the show on Breakfast Club because everybody
and,
knows.
And I agree with you as well.
Is
but
Breakfast
like
Club
you said,
that?
Meek
like,
is in a Beyonce.
You
gotta
go to
it
Breakfast
is.
Club, you
no.
Know
no, it's not that is
it
that, but
it
in
like
terms
that.
Of like platform, the Breakfast
yeah,
Club, they do
the biggest
thing.
Platform.
Come
it's
on
the
now.
Platform?
Yes. It's
no,
one of the
biggest.
Like
in
right
the,
right
in the hip hop
right
culture, it's
like
one of the biggest.
Like
things.
For us, black people. Because
if anything, it's not that it's gonna like make you like watch it, but they'll entice certain like, you know, minutes or like whatever point of view whatever that you want to like hear about so like oh let me fucking tune in that
was yeah. like, I don't like the Breakfast Club like that yeah, it's just something I really want
so,
I like
okay,
like
so
that.
Like
the interviewing skills is trash to me
no it's not
oh, no they interview
honestly
skills is trash
really? Charlamagne got it on point.
Yeah, but DJ Envy be on
the Envy and Angela.
As a collective.
No, but you need them, though.
As a collective.
No,
you don't.
Charlamagne's good, though.
Charlamagne is great, but Charlamagne's like Joe Budden, and no one can fuck with Joe Budden, period, like by himself. You need that little, oh no, Joe Budden.
Yeah,
Biden,
but DJ
Envy
be asking
you,
some
exactly.
dumbass.
You need that little friendly vibe.
So since we on that.
But their skills aren't trash.
What?
It works. It's
exactly.
A
it
works.
It,
you know
it works
because
of who
not
they
trash.
Have
Angela
on.
Always has
not
to research
so
on point.
Them.
So, Envy's that DJ that everybody knows. So.
Yeah, he's like
they
our
need
James.
Each other.
So with that, with the whole like Meek, Rock Nation, right? How y'all feel about Rock Nation, Jay-Z,
and
this whole NFL?
I'm with it.
I'm
with
it, too.
You with it?
I'm fucking with it, bro.
Yo. If I see another tweet about Hov, I'm tweaking.
Niggas
y'all know
so
shit.
Dumb, son.
The fuck y'all be talking about?
I'm sorry,
right?
I the cheap
head,
intro.
Listen, in my head, I'm like, why is Colin
I'm
Kaepernick...
I'm fucking beating your ass.
Well
listen, why is Colin Kaepernick beasting for a job? Didn't you, like, denounce this whole fucking agency? Like, why are you, like,
my thing
crying
because you still got love
job?
For the game. You want to play
it don't
so
matter,
bro. No
like, you saw, you knew what you was doing with that, you know, that sacrifice.
Yeah.
So it was like,
it's just
why now?
Objectively speaking, like, he's better than a lot of niggas that.
That's
he
fine.
That's crazy.
That's
so
fine.
That's the crazy part
that's
about
it.
It
that
you
gotta
know?
Feel
that's,
crazy. No,
but
I'm better
listen,
than
50%
of
why go back to agencies that don't even want you?
Why go back to an agency that doesn't want you?
Yeah. Because
he still got love for that game. The only how he can play that game that he
and
loves.
And then his girlfriend.
That
put it this way.
About, oh, Jay-Z is fucking put talk it. To me and Colin. Bitch, please. Like,
you're right. But
hold
put
on,
it this
hold
way.
On,
is he
hold
required?
Hold on, wait. What'd you say? I hate
you. About,
no, you were saying something.
Before?
Yeah.
I forgot what I was saying before.
Okay.
But Fuck, now I'm thinking about what I was saying before.
Well, I got something to say. Okay, go ahead. I get it. We got Colin Kaepernick.
I remember now.
Like, he kicked it off. Like, mm-hmm. We get it. Everybody's aware. It's like Jay-Z said, everybody's aware, but what's the next step? You can't exactly. Just have people bringing away. It's only so much awareness you can bring before somebody takes an action.
That kneeling down should, like, what does that do?
No one exactly. Else is going to step up, so why not?
It did bring a lot of awareness, but, like, what everybody's saying is, like, oh, you in the check with Colin still got a job. Yo, we can't. So you're saying we can't move forward?
He's going to get a check regardless. Exactly. He don't need the NFL.
He got a check. He settled. Remember?
Bruh. For that book deal.
He's definitely signed to Nike, too.
Yeah.
Nike, exactly. The book deal. Right.
He's not, like, pressing for money.
And he settled with the NFL.
But that's, but so. that I feel like that's not what they was pressing for. My thing is, what? Eric Reed, he plays and for the Panthers and doing all this.
And Eric Reed is not, like, that good.
Oh, he's going to be an owner. And then niggas dug up the tweets when Colin wanted to be an owner and shit. Like,
but you got
to
think
he
of
was never going to be an owner.
He don't got that bread.
Like he said, I'd rather get my foot in the door and try to fix it from within instead of me just, I'm doing this, and they could just shun me like they did.
Exactly.
He did what he did for, you know, whole police brutality, and they shunned him. But now Jay-Z said, okay, I'm not discrediting that. I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to fix it from within. You feel me?
Somebody got to do it.
And he got the money that's going to equip.
Like, and I'd rather have Jay-Z as an owner than have all these predominantly white, older white men.
Because you're going to need these teams. You're going to need some big lawyers. You're going to need some niggas that's going to shake that table. Colin Kaepernick don't got that access. He don't.
At all.
At the end of the day. At Jay-Z
all.
Do.
To actually the access, so the resources, the financials, none of that. Like,
who else they waiting on? Like, y'all want the help.
Like, he got his thing going on. This is my thing going on. Like, it's...
There's only so many commercials.
Yeah,
I definitely
feel like something.
Bread.
Something. So words and Nike commercials ain't getting nothing done, son. Let Hove do what he got to do.
There's only so much that Nessa on Hot 97 can do.
And like, she gotta calm down. But she be fucking his shit up too. Cause every time he about to get,
she really does.
He kind of he did a couple things to fuck himself.
Nessa,
up.
His girlfriend.
Like, he had a chance to sign Nessa with the Dolphins. Nigga wore the Fidel Castro shirt in Miami. Why would you do that?
Yeah.
Like, that was dumb. He was about to get signed to Baltimore, and she did that dumb shit. They both be bugging sometimes.
Like, for her to even speak out on Jay's talking about, oh, he never spoke to Colin, da da da. Like, bitch,
why you
like,
gotta speak to him?
Exactly. Yeah, like, you making shit sound
they
like.
They saying this shit like this nigga's fucking Malcolm X.
I'm fucking Sean Carter. I ain't talking to nobody.
Like, what?
She fucking his shit
up. I am the GOAT. I do whatever I want.
I don't need your okay. I respect your movement, but I don't need your okay to move forward.
Definitely don't. Definitely don't, huh?
Like, what? Like, he's supposed to bring him on board?
They was
like,
oh, Jace is the capitalist. Da, da, da. Okay. And what's wrong with that?
Boy, they want him to do it for free.
I mean, wait. That probably would have been
terrible. At the end of the...
If Jay-Z would have probably brought Cap on to owning the team...
No, how?
No, it doesn't work like that. That's not even the, like, discussion.
He,
like,
has no money to kick forward to owning the team.
Yeah,
at
like...
At all.
What was the settlement? Like, $100 million?
No, but if you think about it, it's like, $100 million. Why would Cap want to come back to the team?
First of all, we don't know. Yeah, nigga signed the NDA. Nah, so yeah, we don't know. But it ain't no $100 million. I guarantee you that. He's not getting $100 million from the NFL for that. It was probably like a calm 50 max. 50 max. The NFL.
You gotta think about it, bro. Yeah, they
drag that shit out before they pay him $100 million.
How much they tried to book him for
the Super Bowl? No, Nike signed him to some wild shit.
Nike signed him to some wild shit. All right, but niggas mad at Ho, but niggas not mad at Nike. Nike don't give a fuck about Colin Kaepernick and what he's doing. That was a point for them to make bread. They know if they get Colin Kaepernick, sell some shirts with Kaepernick on them, they gonna make bread.
Yeah.
Nike don't give a fuck about no. Come on.
But no, wait. The only reason why I say that, because, you know, Nike do be pushing different agendas.
They
like,
do.
Yeah.
Well, no, like, they make definitely money. Like pushing like
for
the whole like
right now.
I don't want to say it wrong, but hijab, like the Nike drop for hijab, like some nobody would have thought outside the box.
But
shit
do
like
they
that.
Really care, or do they know this is going to make
money? It's all about
Nike's a corporation, bro. They don't give a fuck about none of that shit.
And Kaepernick was not about to bring that
like,
brand.
They don't
so.
No type of charities in the hood. They don't even like sponsoring schools in the hood. That's why every school, like you see in the hood, that's Nike and sports, sponsored by Adidas and all them other companies. They ain't sponsored by Nike. Nike
well, my high school is sponsored by Nike. So.
You in Mount Vernon.
I went to Mount Vernon.
A predominantly black city.
Elementary school.
Where the fuck is that at?
Valesburg area. What are you talking about? Like Ivy Hill?
That's Ivy Hill. I don't count
in
either.
The what?
That's where? Maplewood.
What school she went to?
No, it's not. Mount Vernon.
She said what?
Yes, it is. I went to Valesburg. We used to steal y'all bikes.
Like, so you probably stole my bike when I was younger.
Did. Yo. Was black.
I was mad as hell. Like.
Yo, what?
Now, we used to go up there and steal bikes. But bruh. That's the story. My
she
bad.
About a different Mount Vernon.
I hate
nah,
you
she, she's talking about Mount Vernon, Newark. He's from Mount Vernon, New York.
I'm from New York.
Like, okay.
She you know, from Syracuse.
All right, with that being
don't
said.
Don't make that face. What you talking about?
With that being said, I'm really loving like the whole like these black artists, black people, like these black high figures trying to take over sports.
Yeah.
Cause you know, like we already involved in it heavy.
We took over sports.
So, I mean, it's on a couple though.
But I'm just saying, we got that. Now, Jay-Z, I feel like Jay-Z, Rock Nation doing this shit with NFL can bring some.
You know how many agents
yeah,
they
if you think about
also,
it, no, but he's
hey,
only
and
one.
And now we have Rich Paul.
Hey, peep this no. too. You saw somebody out the other day.
But that's a start.
What you mean?
No. Hold up.
Yeah, we got one. Like, that's a start.
Hold up.
But like, wait. But we've been had. Was it Shaquille O'Neal?
He has a sports agency?
No, but I'm saying like he's been into the whole sports game in terms of like, you know.
But Shaquille O'Neal don't really get like
he's
money.
That's as far as
I'm saying. Jay-Z's the only one who's been like, you know.
Because Jay-Z, no. Jay-Z took over basketball first. He jumped in
Shaquille
basketball first.
But
then he did baseball.
Magic Johnson has his home. He has his own. He's
Jordan
a part owner
a team.
Of like a baseball team.
Uh-huh. Michael Jordan has a team. Even though he's an asshole, but like.
Yeah, but it was the Bobcats. That's like you got the Bobcats for
but Magic
the
Johnson has the LA Dodgers.
But the Dodgers were doing so bad for so long. They were about to
that's
sell
like
the
don't
same
part ownership
that's what I'm
of the
saying.
Raptors.
Yeah,
it's a collective effort.
It's
like,
not like
you,
that
as long as you get inside the door. That's
you just
got to
get in the door.
And the reason why he bought
but
the Dodgers was because of
Magic
Drake
Johnson,
is
he
doing
retired because they played his ass out.
Spike
so
Lee is doing
I ain't gonna lie, this nigga Aubrey, that nigga owns the Raptors.
He don't own
Dre
the
hit a goat.
Yeah, okay, James.
He
what?
Don't own the
Raptors. No, no, I'm saying, but like the Raptors.
He has like a small state.
Yeah, I'm saying.
But he's
like,
the brand ambassador,
like,
so it looked like he do. Because
like,
they know
like,
that's going
like
to bring them bread, is Drake. You're going to bring free agencies because of Drake.
And I'm Canadian too, so.
You Canadian too?
Yes.
Jesus.
You Canadian, you live in Mount Vernon, you here at the podcast.
Yes.
What's your life about?
I do every day.
Bye, out. Go interview with one of
God damn.
And I speak French, so what's up?
Oh, Lord.
I'm fluent. You said, oh, Lord.
I mean, you
who
I
said,
mean,
oh,
you,
Lord.
You lived in Canada. You better speak French. You know what I'm saying?
Nigga, for a year.
It don't matter.
So you're not Canadian for real?
No, I am. No, for real, for real.
We're from Montreal.
I got my whole citizenship and everything.
I never said nothing about a year. I said you lived
oh,
in Canada.
Oh, she was born there and moved here.
Yeah,
like
I was
a year
born
later,
here.
And then boom. Lived there for a year. My bad.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
Interesting.
Oh, Lord.
Very.
But yeah,
I'm
side note,
Canadian,
I wanted
it.
To bring this up too, but QC actually is about to jump into sports
who?
Agencies.
Oh, really?
QC
about to get a pop on his
head. Nah, please stop. Bro, don't act like they don't make superstars over there.
They don't.
City Girls?
First,
QC.
Oh, speaking of City Girls,
Stefflon Don?
Young Miami
QC.
Stop rapping. She don't want to rap, bro. Let's stop rapping.
All these
QC did not make Stefflon Don or City Girls.
I'm not saying they didn't.
Girls.
I didn't Stefflon say they make them, but like that's they are breaking these
cool.
rules.
No, they're not.
Hell yeah.
They're not.
Absolutely.
They're
you don't tell me otherwise.
You know who that is?
They're not.
Stefflon Don.
You know who that is, man.
Hurting me?
City Girls was already lit before then.
But guess who
Young
took
Miami
them
gotta
to
give
the next
it up,
level?
Bro.
No, it's a bit more official.
Who took it to the
by
next level?
By signing them to QC. But
you
they were already
deny,
lit.
You can't deny the credibility.
Yeah, you
I
can. You can't.
I
you
can.
You can't.
Yes, I can.
Oh, Lord.
They was working with Gucci before Gucci was Gucci.
Okay.
Nah, Gucci was Gucci.
It wasn't QC,
oh,
though.
Oh, my God.
Nah, Gucci
was. Do your homework, man.
Who was working with Gucci before Gucci was Gucci?
Coach and P, bro. Do your homework.
What?
Gucci made Atlanta right now.
Guess what?
I'm not saying
QC
I'm not saying nothing
like
about
Coach,
right now.
No,
I said before.
Gucci,
Migos. Okay, that's what I'm
Gucci
saying.
She can't say the Migos.
What?
Garbage.
You don't like the Migos?
You just
I like them.
You just trying to piss
oh,
me
okay,
off.
Oh yeah, because
fuck off.
But
that's
still on some bullshit. Like
he Migos.
Yeah, they on some bullshit. Nah, I can admit when they. You know what I'm saying? But Rob just trying to be an asshole. So fuck you, Rob.
My bad, bro.
Yeah, fuck you.
But since that whole PC shit, niggas listen to their tape.
I ain't listening to
I'm not listening to 36 bro. Tracks right now.
Nah.
That shit with Meg is fire, though. Shout out
a
to
couple
Marcus.
Yeah,
whoever whoever said Pastor, they got
hot.
Some hits, too. No
yeah,
fun
they definitely got some hits.
City Girls got a song on there.
Yes.
Cool.
That
I like Back
slap.
Out by Lil Baby.
That shit slap.
Back on, back
there.
On, back on, back on.
Yeah, back on. I'm sorry.
That shit slap.
Back on.
They got some stuff on there.
Pink Toes. Shout out to all the pretty feet, them.
Hey.
He bet that shit. Nigga didn't even laugh. Nigga said it was straight face.
You like feet?
Yeah.
You know a lot of black men love feet.
Niggerologist.
You'd be selling. Oh, no, correction. Would you sell feet pics?
I would.
You better.
Why would I not? If you want to pay for it, then go ahead.
That's not odd, though.
It's money, bro.
Yeah, that's true.
Real quick. It's a check. Somebody in the back want to know, do you like sucking toes?
That's a yes.
Everybody does suck toes. Yeah. Yeah.
Grow that's a yes. Yeah. And that's a yes. So three yeses in the building. Yes in the building.
Hell yeah.
Jamal, you be looking toes, bro?
Surprise.
Shit, me.
Wait. Who said what?
Shit, me.
Mar said, huh?
Shit, me.
Mar said, you're not sucking toes.
Would you buy, would you buy a foot pick?
No.
Stop looking playing with me,
bro. Hell no. Life is not that rough,
bro. What you mean? When you get the combo, maybe like this.
What combo?
You paying for that?
Oh, no. I'm just saying, like, when your shorty send you the combo.
Of course.
He paid for it.
Nah, if you pay for your shorty nails, you pay the color, she send you a picture after.
Have I paid for girls?
I'm saying, are you paying
for your
girl's nails and toes done?
See.
What about her hair done?
If I sweat it out.
They go, what?
Talk that.
But nah.
So that's the whole sewing and like bundles and all that.
If you got a wig.
Got a wig.
Grab the other one. Grab the third one. The little red
joint. We talked about this before. Niggas have paid for bundles before.
I might do a wig. There's a difference.
You do sewings.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen.
You got a lot of hair. You good.
Exactly.
Stop.
Thanks.
Mom, like, where that shit out? Fuck it. Where that shit out? Put that shit in the crowd.
I just have to throw some water on that shit.
Not the water.
No, fuck it. Come in.
Not the water.
Are we fighting?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a problem.
Bucket and bucket and everything. Like, all that.
We have a problem.
Oh, wow.
With that being said, right? So we're talking about the whole, like, feet shit. So how would you feel about, say he was dealing with a guy and like he was like he had an OD foot fetish, but that's his want, but you don't really fuck with it. Would you feel uncomfortable like indulging into his like?
I'm different, cause if you love it, I love it. So
okay,
if you want to suck my toes, then that's on you. But I'm not gonna force you to do so. But if you want to, all right, cool.
Put this foot in your mouth.
How convenient.
Take that wow. Cord real quick.
How convenient is fucking.
I have no corn, so
that
you talking about. Don't play with
me. But hold on, all right. So Bobby, like, say it was like a girl, that like she's into like some back shit. Would you? Nice. How would you?
Like, what's you gotta give her? Yeah.
You gotta eat her ass.
Anyway.
But anywho.
Nah, I've done it before.
Okay, then. Thank you.
That's why I asked, like, what, like, say some, like some weird shit. Like, she got some weird kinky shit going on.
Yeah, you
like
the girl, there ain't no weird shit.
Like that video of that girl that be choking niggas out with her thighs. Nah, you bugging.
That's
shit,
not on
man.
Her, though. That's other niggas.
But some girls might like niggas passing out. Might get her off. I don't know. People weird,
nigga,
bro. Nigga,
if a girl pull up on you talking
right, so
like
say
that,
your
just
girl was like, yeah, I'm about to,
no,
I'm tie you up and put you on the leash.
Hell no, you're not about to do none of that shit. Don't fuck.
Shot.
Excuse me.
Nah,
why not?
Not on a leash.
Why not? Leash?
You gotta really trust somebody to let them tie you up.
You wanna know why
put
not?
Put me on a leash and do what?
You wanna know why not?
What the fuck?
Bark, Robert.
Absolutely.
You barking?
Oh, one up is that.
I was about to say, I know you.
One up is barking.
The time that we absolutely made it sound like
that. That's not what it means.
So,
you put niggas on leashes?
The fuck is wrong with you?
Was he black?
Because listen, if you're going to do whatever to me, so I'm going to do whatever to you as well.
We have a problem.
You can't do whatever I do to
you.
Yo. Everything you do, you're going to do it.
Of course I do.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, throw that
real quick. Throw that real quick. But do you feel like males and females, they like discuss their sexual wants and needs with their partner?
I don't do that.
So you don't tell
no.
whoever you're dealing with no. what you like?
They gotta nope. just figure it
why?
Out.
Why?
Why?
To this fuck shit, you a puzzle?
Nah, this shit kind of fun figuring it out as you go.
Hey, real quick.
Pretty much. Real I'm gonna just like.
Yo, I ain't gonna listen to this. Yo. Yo.
Oh. Hold that's on. Hold on. About. Hold on. Let me pull up the
should
sound effects folder real
what
quick.
I want?
No.
Okay then.
You should be able to figure out. We grown
thank
enough,
you.
And I think we don't get enough where we
introducing.
We at least know like.
Bad man Bilo, done up.
Bilo the GOAT.
Glow, that's Bilo. Bilo, blow, that's glow. Glow versus glow. But
yeah, I don't feel like I should tell a nigga like what I like in the bed. No, that's not your business to know.
You know the
it's
basics.
For you to find out.
And then you figure the rest out as you go.
Pretty much.
Okay.
Like you should know. Because girls throw hints. They'll throw
I'm
like
down
a little,
for whatever.
Little,
so if you want to be that boss ass nigga to let me know what's up, then.
So I got a question, right?
I want my chips with the dip.
Yeah, I want my chips with the dip. You feel me? You feel me, Aubrey? But say you slamming some shit, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you just like. You throwing your finger in her ass off the first go around?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna try.
Off the like first time you know it.
Yeah, you gotta try.
Because you know some people not into that shit.
I'm not into that, but I'm gonna still let you go.
Oh.
So.
I mean,
you gotta try. If you say know, stop, like, stop. As you do it, you'll know. Like, you know how. Like how she reacts to how she reacts to.
I'm going for 40.
Yeah, like some people just. She might jump. Absolutely. She jumped. But,
I'm not jumping.
Some joints might jump because they not used to shit like that.
I'm
so
just be like,
if she jump, you be like, oh,
she
maybe
said,
I wild a little too much.
I can. Like,
but I mean, if you doing anything, keep going as normal.
Okay, okay. You really can't do that because, like, say, what the fuck? No. Oh, right. Say she a spitter, right? Tell me, Jill, yeah. Say she a spitter, right?
It's been a while, you know what I'm saying?
Are you gonna tell, like, yeah, my mother just let off? Say she a spitter.
Huh?
If she's a spitter and she's not a swaller.
Okay. She's a spitter. I'm
I like
her,
you
though.
Both.
Is she a spitter?
But how would you know? You don't. That's the first time.
Nigga, you asked. Yo, all you say, I'm about to come. And then she keeps
not,
talking.
It's no warning.
No,
you
listen. No.
Hold on. You, listen to her. Nah, listen to her. You need to listen to her. You need to listen to her.
No.
You need to listen to what Lady Glow about to tell you right now.
Hold on. Hold on. I'm a female, okay?
Okay.
All right. So if you saw, like, I'm about to come. And she's like, okay, you know, come. And she's still sucking. That means, come my fucking mouth, bitch. The fuck you talking about? What?
So there's no way y'all
listen,
don't feel that shit before
hold
I
on.
Come out.
No, because listen. Because if you say, I'm about to come, and she's like, oh, okay. And she like, does it.
I'm like, hey, you child, I'm never coming back here. I don't like this part.
If she starts her fucking dick and her mouth is already off, so you know what's up.
I ain't coming back here no more.
Exactly.
Yeah, I'm gonna just.
So
I'm gonna leave my tip and walk out the door.
Yo, what is that from? That video. Oh my god.
So if she says okay,
yo.
And keep going, like you know. So you know what's up.
I'm with all that shit.
Yeah, I'm with all that.
Go ahead and give me that facial.
So,
dead? Like,
some joints do like they face painted.
Real quick.
You are watching a master.
Anyway, guys, do y'all be like, do y'all tell like a girl, like, say something that you want that she don't do? How y'all break it down to her?
Like, what? Like,
she I'm gonna hear this bullshit.
Okay, like, say this.
Wow.
Say it's a girl. Okay.
Because I know y'all don't know.
Since
that's
we were
kinda,
on,
honestly,
since we were on fellatio, I'm gonna address her in a second, though. I just wanna get this out.
Okay.
Since we were on fellatio, right? So, say.
Having to ask for head, that's ghetto as hell.
Yeah.
Let him talk. Let's
but,
talk.
Like, say the head, not as, like, maybe, like, as sloppy as you want it.
Oh, mm-hmm. Lord.
You want some water?
Or whatever the case may be. Now, if you telling her, straight up, like, yeah, this shit not hitting for that. Or this shit not, like, it's cool, but can you spit a little bit more? Like, now she gonna be feeling some type of way, like. But
yeah,
say you keep saying it, like, yeah, get that shit wet. I'm trying.
A bitch like me, like, if you say that, oh, come on, get the shit wet more. I'm like, okay, all right, thank God, because I need some direction if I can talk about, like, you know, so, like, that's
are
me.
You so, are like, you guided?
Pretty much, I'm tired sucking dick right now, like, you know. Please give me the fucking direction, Lord. Like, what can talk about? So, oh, it's, I'm, like, I'm fucking spitting as much as you want. Oh, wow. Like, fuck you talking about?
But it's some girls that be trying.
Nigga said, we like,
yo, nobody said, you ever got air from a girl with cotton mouth?
Yeah,
yes.
I snapped
your
dick back.
No, when you got the knife, y'all was just smoking and shit. And she like, yo, all right, this ain't it. Huh? Yeah, you gotta hydrate before. You gotta give like a Gatorade, electrolytes.
Yo, this nigga said, I snatched my dick back.
The funny thing is, you guys think that women want to shit. Listen, you guys think that women want to be sucking dick for like hours upon hours. No, nigga.
Perk me.
No. Yo. No. Listen.
Yo, when she thinks she about to hey, yo. Shit, you took a perk shit,
yo. Perk me. I'm about listen. To
after 10 minutes, we're tired. Like, listen, okay. That little...
All right, and y'all be wanting head for like 30 minutes too. Oh, fuck you talking about?
What?
Nah, I'm not eating pussy for 30 minutes.
You want me to repeat myself? Like,
listen,
definitely
listen.
Eating box for 30 minutes.
Yeah, that's cool.
All we need is a good little 10 minute little.
Why the fuck you?
Because it be sometimes
30 minutes.
It be sometimes.
And then that little dick comes in.
Nah, bro, it be sometimes.
Yeah,
30 minutes. I'm not doing
it. Okay, 15 minutes. Fuck you talking about?
What, 15 minutes ahead?
Yes. And then
you just said y'all tied at the 10. This is an equal opportunity.
Yeah, 10 minutes.
Yeah, 10 minutes is valid. 10 minutes is valid.
Stick your penis in. And do what you gotta do.
Anyway. time.
But anywho.
But I was saying, like, it be sometimes that, like, the head be so fire, you don't nut in 10 minutes.
Oh, that's the problem.
You're trying to right. Save it.
I'm trying
nigga.
To enjoy it.
I'm trying
listen,
to,
yeah. My mouth was already sore at that point.
That don't got nothing to do with me.
Listen,
that
listen.
Shit
listen nah,
it is true though.
I'm a champ. So listen, I'll go around. But I'm not happy to go around. But
understood.
I'm just saying.
Niggas
like,
never hold off though.
Unless
you get the next person you have to, then like, boom.
I want my chip back to
commission
get,
by that.
No,
Yeah,
how much you want?
Nah,
it's
too
like much.
Yeah,
thank
half
God.
10 minutes is too much.
Nigga, I love my dick sucked.
Well then,
because anything more than 10 minutes, I'm like switching like
10 minutes
positions, like
strong 10 minutes.
Bruh.
10 minutes of good head is not happening, bro.
What?
10 minutes of OD.
Shit,
bro.
Off the second round? You bugging. Oh, no. Off the second, of course.
So I've been too nice.
Yeah, you're going to be watching the whole movie. Like,
I've been too nice, then.
Bro, I like, yeah.
I've been too nice, then.
Spit on it. Keep going.
Yeah, whole
you going to watch Titanic next.
Yeah, this nigga watching the whole marathon of Martin and shit. Getting
wait,
some
hold
back,
on. All right, so what's the longest head for you is what?
No, I got some more.
Sheesh.
Okay, I'll tell you the distance.
I'm up to no good.
I've got head from Maryland to beginning to the end of Jersey, like over the bridge.
That's an hour.
I don't
that's
even think hour. I have a drive.
It's like 45.
No,
it's like
45.
Okay, so 45.
Like
30.
Like
30? Okay, yeah. What about you?
I like 25, 25.
25 minutes? Okay.
Half, she shows the whole episode.
So I've done longer than that, so that's a problem. So if you guys are saying that's good enough, so,
so if you suck a dick for hour, that means your mouth.
We
don't
have
work.
A problem.
Yo. Mouth broke up.
Oh really?
I mean, I don't know.
We have a problem.
Hour?
No, I wouldn't say that.
Like then you got you kept going. No, it was just an hour.
So 45 minutes, and then he finally, you know, came and you know.
Okay.
We have
but
a problem.
That's a problem. Because like,
I was driving, so you know, like. You don't really nut from roadhead.
You're trying to concentrate on it.
Yeah, I'm looking at like,
you don't count.
That shit like this.
That's a Mississippi place. You don't see that one.
I think it's like, wow. All
right, so let's ask this. Okay. So do you guys normally come from like just getting head, period?
Depends
on if the mouth like a pussy.
Yeah, it depends on who giving it.
Yo, it's been sometimes. Yo, which one else was telling the story about? Yo, hold up, wait. Who said the story? Yo, right when Shorty about to put the dick in her mouth, he nutted.
Wait, what?
We was at 8 crib. Oh, yeah.
Yo.
Remember y'all on the podcast. Yeah, we did. Jelly.
Nah, that wasn't it.
It
wasn't it.
Nah, we ain't gonna say the name who it was.
Yeah, but like, the nigga said he didn't like, even get the head. No. Like, he didn't even get the head. Like, I guess she was like.
See, the funny thing is, hold on. Let's pause this real quick, because you gotta be fucking talking like y'all got the little big dick band and all that. Like, listen.
Nigga, what?
So, listen, hold on. What's your head game like? What you talking about, huh?
Nigga, what? Dirty. I like you.
What's good, like?
We want to
know. No!
Am I eating pussy 45 minutes?
So listen, no. How long before a bitch fucking squirt? Before she fucking, come on, nut? All that. Listen, I'll put my whole leg up.
She is talking the absolute. You are.
Bruh.
Is it because you sit in an ant chair? Yeah, you coming like this? I don't.
It's a spirit of ant.
I don't understand what this is.
I'm tired of being so, like, you know.
This ain't your first podcast.
No. I'll text somebody your ass.
Listen, it ain't my first rodeo.
Shout out to the Featured On podcast that I'm on. I'm the first lady on that shit. So, you know, we talk our shit. So, you
okay.
Talking that cash. All right?
But, anywho.
About to get a record.
But real
how
quick.
How long before
what are you talking about?
A bitch is like squirming?
What the fuck are you talking about?
How long before she's squirming? It don't take that long for the squirm.
Yeah, squirm probably like 45 to 30.
How long before she's fucking squirming your fucking face?
Seconds.
Oh, it depends.
34
seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen,
but I'm that sperm coming like soon as
minutes, though. That's not happening.
Wait, so you eat ass? And
soon as I
depends on who it is.
I don't like ass.
You don't like what?
I don't like my ass being eaten. So I'm just saying.
You asking a lot of questions, though.
More power to you.
But yeah, no, definitely. I feel like a lot of people should.
No, we're asking should you what? How long does it take for you to fucking make a bitch squirm?
James, I got you, bro. Hold on. She ask her, hold on. She asked you all of these questions. Yeah. I got you, bro. Hold up.
You the police?
Okay.
You the FBI?
You the FBI? CIA?
Yes, I am. Okay.
Whoever I ever went down on, they know how to give it up.
Oh, boy.
It depends on the time of the day. You know how
no one nuts on the same amount of time. Like, oh, yeah, she coming over. I should be done by 9:45. I should have done it by then. Like, it don't work like that. Some
she
people
not,
shit.
Oh, but I'll say this, though. She's not.
You see how
minutes.
Niggas ain't shit?
Excuse me.
You see how niggas ain't shit?
I'm going to say it. She's not under 5 minutes, though.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely. Especially if you know her, like you know how she, you know how her shit work. It's not
what we say. What we say? Jumpstart,
my boy James.
Jumpstart the box.
Jumpstart the boom.
Y'all want anything under 5 minutes? Come see James.
I feel like a lot of people should explain what they want with their partner.
But
what
please,
they don't like.
They don't.
So if you don't like something, you
listen,
gonna tell them?
I'm single.
Oh, yeah, if you don't like something,
so,
you gonna tell
if you, but
niggas don't fucking come. Can't, oh. Blah, blah, blah. They don't do that.
Like, if I don't like when she's doing something, I'm gonna tell her.
I'm telling her.
No, but I'm saying, like, a nigga like me, like, listen, a person like me, a nigga's not gonna, like, you know, come, like, oh, I put it down. You're not doing that. Because, one,
why won't he?
They're intimidated by my, how I, you know, present myself.
How's
that
intimidating?
Oh, Lord.
You intimidating?
Am I not?
I don't feel like
ain't nobody here intimidating.
Really?
What? You know what? You know what, sis? Go. You know what? Talk your shit. No. Hold on. Talk your shit. Talk your shit.
I feel attacked. Okay.
No.
The niggas you the niggas you come across are intimidated by me. Yes. Go ahead.
Okay. I'll say. Okay.
If I have my makeup on, maybe. Okay. But whatever.
No, I got nothing. No, you know what it is? Like your personality might be a little intimidating.
Yeah,
you know how
it's pretty strong. Like I'm.
Yeah, like certain women, when you meet them first, they kind of like standoffish.
Yeah,
so
I'm not that.
Back. Yeah, you know what I'm saying.
Personalities came out bow. So
and
that might
talk
be too much.
And we've talked about us and the whole attraction of alpha females. Later, you know, she'll walk in the room and she's gonna have that motherfucker.
Yeah, nobody complaining.
We like that.
She gonna have that.
Over there.
Get my body.
That assertive energy.
Back,
you know what I'm saying? Yeah, hell yeah. That's
my. You know that.
It's important.
RP Tech,
boy,
nine, man.
So listen, y'all all ain't shit.
Wow. Can we get a substitution on the court, please?
But anywho,
depends on who I'm dealing with.
So,
I might not be
but
shit.
Anywho,
I might be shit.
So you're not.
Wait, hold on.
You're not toxic? Because I feel a lot of toxic energy coming off.
Listen, I'm the perfect fucking bitch you ever be with.
So, but okay, I know so you have some ain't shit tendencies, though. I can tell.
Hell yeah.
Okay. So then you ain't shit then.
I can choose to be ain't shit.
Same here. That's how we all are.
No, but you can
be listen. I could be a blessing.
No, I'm not naturally ain't shit. I just decided to be ain't shit depending on who I'm dealing with at the time. I could be dealing with somebody and I'm could be the best nigga in the world.
And how old are you?
28.
Okay.
But certain joints, I just not care. So I'ma just act how I want. That's that. This all is right, how
well,
it is.
Here. So
but nah, for real though. I could be a blessing to one, I could be a lesson to the other.
Or please.
I guess so.
Like I hate black men. I can but be a blessing to one and then a blessing to the other.
Damn, why we can't be a blessing? We can't be a blessing.
How did we get here? What?
This is just, it's
common. I hate
y'all. It's slander the fellas.
Yes, nah, y'all gotta stop thinking y'all the only ones that just
listen,
like,
I need a little white man. Over
there. Why are you talking?
Oh, cut a microphone, please.
Yo, can we?
I mean, that's a preference.
I'm about to mute you in a second.
That's a preference. That's what she like.
I'm dead about to mute you in a second.
I love black men.
Say it again. I'll mute you right now.
I love black men.
Now, yeah. let her say what she wants.
But, since we on that, who y'all think move more wacky?
Wet
women or men?
I think
who's
men.
Who's more wild?
Men
who's
do
more like more ain't shit?
Then how can I move?
Like, they move more wacky.
All right, look, so look, you got men do more like shit. They like be wild on the regular. But women, when they decide to wild, that should be crazy. We witness some crazy shit.
I can tell
shit.
You that.
Women to move crazy, you just be like, oh wow, yeah. But I'm still with the shits though. But you're listen, wild, like that's crazy.
Listen, as a woman,
oh, look, she looked at the camera,
bruh.
Yeah,
we will love you, but at the end of the day, if you fucking ate, if you're not treating us right, then guess what? We got Michael from Atlanta.
Oh,
he's ready to fucking pipe us up.
You better be safe with that one. Atlanta.
Another nigga from DC, fucking you know,
safe
let us know what's up. Like,
fuck around, fuck around. He gonna get that Atlanta clap.
She got yeah,
Rose Bar, nigga.
Look
at that Noya clap. She got.
These niggas down there ain't real right. I'll tell you, they
losing man weight. What happened?
Don't
can't eat it anymore.
Hold on. This is why I hate Jersey niggas. Y'all fucking hate.
Hold on, where you from? Talk about some you hate Jersey niggas.
Yeah, y'all motherfucking hating on fucking down south niggas, right? Hating
on who? I love DC.
No,
I'm always DC. I'm
going down there.
No, but you said Atlanta.
Atlanta is number one with HIV. That's why we said that.
Because I can't tell who's gay or not.
Hold on.
You can tell somebody how he
is. Definitely can.
Look at that.
Please.
You got a special contact that let you know something? Like,
listen.
No.
Max Johnson got your kid. Don't let him.
No funny. Since you're on that little yeah. ain't shit.
No. I'm not going to lie. Listen, when I was out there for my birthday, I was like, damn. It's a hella fucking sus motherfuckers out here. And I'm
Atlanta
like,
got
fuck?
Some women too. They got a lot of hella women.
Yeah, but it's a lot of fucking sus ass niggas. I was just like, oh, hell no.
Where you from?
I'm from Jersey.
She from Canada.
She from everywhere, bro. She from Canada. She from Jersey. She from motherfucking Timbuktu, my nigga. I don't know what the fuck is up with her.
Motherfucking,
Kansas.
Oh, am I? Nah, they can hear me. They can hear me.
Oh, am I?
I don't know where you from. You say you from everywhere.
Yo, I'm from Australia.
Shot. Anyway, with that, like, since we just talking about the whole A shit, I got a question.
I'm killing the nigga who get, I would give you fucking...
Shot.
Go ahead.
They'll kill you first.
Yeah.
Move fast.
I don't even
the
do
whole
wrong,
shit
so
with like
nah.
The whole shit with like STDs, STIs.
I don't do that.
Oh Lord.
How do y'all go about like asking somebody
people,
like
oh, no.
when you meet them?
I'll tell you.
Asking somebody.
I'll tell them. Oh, you good?
Ask
right?
them what.
You good? They gonna lie.
You good?
Word, like, you trust that person to tell you the truth?
Like, the reason why I ask that, you know how, like,
am I good? Like, do I want to do this?
The reason why I ask that, you know how, like, say sometimes something may happen, you know, you fall into some box, right?
I don't play that.
You can fall into some box.
I'm gonna kill them.
You can fall into some dick, though. But, like, y'all didn't plan on fucking none of that
okay.
shit, right? Mm-hmm. What is the judgment that you be like,
I'll ask
it.
Them, are you good, right? Because I'm good.
They're going to think something else, like, good, like, do I got a condom? Yeah.
No.
Am I good? Don't want to do this?
No,
hell yeah,
no.
bitch, you see me?
Listen,
hell yeah, I want to do this.
I'll ask them, listen.
You see
condom?
This coat, nigga?
No. Yeah, I don't, but all right, fuck. You good, right? And I looked at him like that. You good, right?
No, has a nigga ever said no?
No, but they know how I'm coming. So, like, what are you talking about?
The
like,
reason why it's funny because...
Oh, they know your body.
You know how, like, say the first time you hear some shit wrong... And then the next day,
don't do that.
You be thinking hella shit. You be like,
no. These are out here wrong, dog.
The commercials start coming on.
Tapes.
This should be like,
yeah, the side effects might include
something. So how does it go? How does it go with you? Go ahead.
Well, with me, like, first I'm gonna hit some shit raw.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't just randomly like hit shit raw. Like, it's definitely
so how does it go then?
It's a buildup.
Yeah, like, yeah.
Hold on.
We definitely had that.
What's the buildup?
Usually women bring that shit up though.
Which
like
is
they
what?
Bring that shit up.
Are
like,
you good?
Like, yeah, sure.
Hell
okay,
yeah.
Then, thank you.
Yeah, I've never heard that. Are you good?
I never heard that. Are you good, though? I don't think, like,
oh,
like,
like they just
like,
trust
yeah,
you.
Right.
Because the reason why I said that is because I remember one time I asked a girl about results.
My are you good is, do you have any STDs?
But he can lie to you.
Okay, and if he does, I'm now, if I get something, I'm suing your ass. Period.
Well, not for nothing.
You can send it to him.
Not for nothing. If the nigga lied to you, you a terrible judge of character.
How?
How you not know the nigga a liar up until that point?
I'm asked for full on.
Nigga gonna lie about mad other shit.
I'm God.
You know.
Nah, yeah. You don't gotta be God to know if somebody's lying or not. It's an intuition thing.
Oh. You
gotta put all this
gotta
shit
hand me up with that.
It's not, yeah, like, it's not that hard. Sorry, like, maybe I'm just talking shit.
Right.
Maybe I'm just talking shit. But it,
I date older men. So.
In my experience, like I know when somebody's lying. Like you know, what
she
saying?
Got
like,
ranch.
How old are you?
Ranch.
I'm 25.
Okay, that's why.
But that what? Doesn't attest to anything. You don't know who I've been involved with.
No,
he
doesn't
know
how to judge character. Older men, they don't like lie on that shit. Like,
I've dated older women and they be lying about shit. People
old
lie.
Be the worst.
Age, yo, age has nothing to do with maturity at all. I know you know that. I know you know that.
Age limit on STDs? The fuck?
There are people that are well in their 30s that are still moving like they
don't even
know
they got some shit. They think a bitch burned up. They burned up.
So let's not talk about age. Like that got nothing to do with maturity at all. People move how they want to, regardless of age.
Please be wise.
Be wise.
Am I lying?
Definitely be wise. And don't be scared to get tested. Like I had somebody that I was fucking with heavy, like my ex, and she was like, "Yo, we gotta get tested for you."
How did she?
At that time, which was like 24, 25.
But the reason why I bring that up just because like the whole like we did the whole collab with we are that pod, and like they was heavy on like the STD shit. So it's like, I mean, yeah, you feel me? Like, a lot of people don't really take it serious.
Oh, I take it serious.
But, like,
one
these
life,
days,
one body, you can't be.
Especially if you're out here doing your shit, make sure you're getting your ass checked. Like,
duh. Like,
ladies, guys.
But the people who be wild and wild, they don't get checked.
I know. Because
they be like, yeah, I'm going to
practice safe sex and absence.
Because mind you, I only like to have
yo, get
raw
the fuck
sex
out
with
here.
My nigga.
Huh?
I said, I only like to have raw sex with my nigga.
You should, as you should.
Period.
You shouldn't be.
So you're not my man.
Raw dog, yeah, randoms.
I prefer to be celibate, or if you really got me on like a good night, then, you know,
yeah, been celibate.
Or wrap it up. But other than that,
been celibate
you did
for
the
a few years.
With the wrap it up.
You remember when BT was doing that whole wrap it up shit? That was shit me. I'm good. But at the time.
That's what I'm saying. Niggas really do.
Copy.
And nigga said, I'm good.
Copy.
Anyways.
But since
I'm a lady.
Alright, so you saying, like, you know, you only get the raw peeing from your man. So say you got two men, right?
Yikes.
Do you feel like you could be in love with two people at one time?
Cause,
huh?
No.
Huh?
No.
Huh?
No.
This will be interesting.
Yeah.
Huh?
No.
One more time.
The type of, no.
What are you talking to right now?
I will never be in love with two men at the same time.
What did you say, nigga? But why is that though? Why is that?
Cause I would never put myself in that position.
Okay. Alright. So I'm gonna give you a quick little scenario.
That's a great answer.
Go ahead.
And I'm gonna see if you're gonna fold. You was with one guy, right?
Mm-hmm.
You was with him for like 4 years.
Make it seven.
Seven.
This is the most serious I ever see, James.
you was with him for like 7 years. Y'all had a little fallout. You met somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
She got this principles, bro. It's over.
Wait. This new person is doing things that the person you was with for 7 years not doing. So now you fall in love
That's
with
That's cute.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
She got principles. So she got prerequisites.
So now you got both the qualities that you want. You got qualities from one that you love in a nigga, and the other nigga got those same qualities. Are you able to be with both? Or
no. You know why?
She got both, bro, care about over. Both,
no.
Love both.
Because the nigga that's shown me some new qualities, I don't believe it. Because it's just been that first couple what? Months.
So you don't cheat?
No. He's just showing me what he wants to show me.
But maybe maybe he's just showing it to you.
No, he's not forcing it. Nigga, please.
So at what point do you feel
listen,
like it's forever?
Hold on, no.
You wouldn't let yourself get to that.
Listen,
point.
No. Because if you want to talk about it, like, listen. In terms of a girlfriend, I'm that bitch. I'm the best fucking girlfriend ever. Like, I will fucking, like...
I've heard that.
And that's cute. Okay, that's fine. But listen. I'm lit, all right?
Okay.
So, if another nigga trying to fucking, like, you do what the, you know, what the next nigga didn't do for me, then it's that's cute. But I need a whole year of that fucking report card of his fucking good behavior. Because I've been putting that work. So...
Makes sense.
Thank you.
You want that consistency first before you.
So then why is there like some girls, they like they saw a nigga more than they made nigga?
Yikes.
I don't think so.
Nah, they really don't like
that. Girls do not like their boyfriends. Can you tell her?
Nah. I'm gonna be 100% honest.
We've been talking about this for a minute.
We have this talk a lot amongst ourselves because really? Wild shit be going on. A lot of girls really don't like, it seems like they don't like their boyfriend.
You know what they really like?
Like they boyfriend, you know, they nigga all that block that blah 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 blah. They'll block you, unblock you later. Yo, what's up?
I
have
like two girlfriends.
I want my chips with a dip.
You have somebody girlfriend hit you up and ask you why you not showing them attention. So what does that say about?
I want my chips with a
dip. Nah, that just means that their
it's an outlet
that their boyfriend wasn't like doing the bullshit that they want him to do.
Okay, but so now say the boyfriend is doing all the extras, making him happy. They doing the posts. All that shit.
All you doing is dropping dick off and probably getting some eats. That's it.
Being a girl's a hoe. She don't want you. Yeah, I'm about to say, that's on her. Yeah.
Nah, I ain't think about it.
Because listen, if you a good ass nigga and he does all that for you,
because they can be in love and the dick not hitting for them.
Oh, that's listen.
So, you can be in love with a nigga and be in love with another dick.
But listen, some people.
Whoa. So you can be in love with a nigga.
No.
And be in love with another nigga dick.
You can't. Because you're not in love with a nigga who can't satisfy you in that way.
What?
Period.
Huh?
If his dick is not hidden, she's not in love with you, bro.
Huh?
Period. So she's using you. What the fuck?
But there are girls that don't leave even though the sex
because you do a lot of more shit. Because you either paying for her nose, you doing this and that.
Hold on real quick. So do you feel like those girls aren't being honest with themselves?
Clearly. Bitch, no, I've went through a little dick.
Yo, shout out to Crazy Bone.
Listen, I'm not sticking around for a little dick. Sorry.
Okay.
Can't knock it. Can't
I respect it though, because that's because like sex is like important to you as far as
it's important. Okay, Fight for number two. But Bobby, do you feel like Bobby Blanco, the men of the room?
Wait, hold on.
Do we feel like we could be in love with two women at the same time?
Yes.
It's 1,000%.
I used to think so.
Bitch, please.
But now looking back, nah. Because when I looked at a situation where I felt like that,
crazy.
I wasn't. Huh?
Listen, females already crazy.
So?
First of all, you already see my energy. So if I was your girlfriend, nigga.
It's always a way.
Do you?
Where's the will is a way.
Me and God. Yo, listen, I'm on your ass 24-7. What the fuck you talking about?
Gotta be quicker than that.
Gotta be quicker than that.
Listen. I'm at your house before you fucking wake up.
I'm not going home.
Which house? Which phone am I texting
all
you
of us.
Like, nah, I'm not that toxic.
All of us.
Now with every type of nigga, though.
Huh? What'd you say?
All of them.
All of them?
Okay.
Copy.
Multiple names.
Because you know what?
She don't got that phone that's in the gas cap.
If you want to play them games.
Wicked out here. Y'all got me safe.
Yeah, I got to go get some gas, nigga, outside.
If you
want
to play them
games.
Yeah,
the phone behind the gas cap. They don't know about that, bro.
I could play the same games. You hear me?
You could, but you got to catch me first.
I could play them better than you. I could play them better than you.
We just going to hurt each other. But at the end of the day, as long as we console each other, at the end of the day.
No, I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that.
You know what that sounds like?
I'm gonna kill you.
Niggas always come back to that toxic box, man.
I'm up to no good.
Yeah, sadly.
For real.
Nah, but I don't think you can be in love. Me as a mature adult now, I can't.
It's hard to give like your all to two different people.
Because the reason why I started fucking with one so heavy, because I was really off the other one at that time.
Okay, like you always, somebody's always winning.
It's always on and off. It's never two at the same level.
And it's like, oh, she pissing me off, but she making me happy.
Nah, you can't even fall for that though. Because there'd be times you'd be mad at your shorty and the next shorty be like, ah, bye bye. It seemed good. For the time being.
Duh.
But after a while, you can be like, oh, nah, she a dub, I'm out.
Stupid.
But it's been times where it's like, oh, I'm out. I'm going over there. And I went over there. I like this.
Yeah, because, you know, this part. She pissed you off.
And they like to think when you leave, you're not going to be better off. It's been times I've been better off after I left. Oh, you bugging.
Nigga, please. Not a bitch like me. Fuck you. That's what you think.
Be good.
She's talking to her.
Period.
She is. She's talking. She's talking to her.
That's it. But anyway. You know, you'd be better off. You'd be better off, man. But then now I think about it.
Huh? These niggas still single, though.
You single.
Wait.
I choose to be.
You and your shorty, right? Y'all get to a point where now y'all, like, things are falling out. You with your side nigga, he with his side bitch. Y'all running to each other.
We got to get you a microphone. What you
doing? I'm going to repeat it.
So
B-Lo was saying that me and my shorty, we on bad terms.
Yeah.
She catch me in traffic with my little side joint, and I catch her in traffic
with her side nigga.
What happens?
It's a group date. Fuck, I want to know about you. Fuck
family
you for
function?
Family function? Well, all right. Well, nah, bitch, like me, one, I'm not, I deny. So, one.
If I catch you in traffic with.
You can't deny that.
You can't deny that.
He's my friend. What you talking about?
He's your friend.
He's my friend too.
How convenient is that?
I'm gonna tell you something. It's some spots you cannot go with just friends.
Yes. Listen, you don't know me. That's my friend.
Don't know
we went to that same spot.
I'm a whole nigga. I know you.
That's my friend.
No.
Liar. That's my friend.
Know all your friends by that.
No, I don't give a fuck.
Where this friend come from?
That's my friend.
Is he wrong?
He can do that. That's cute, but that's all my friend.
So you pull like up. So you pull up. See your nigga. You see him, and he with his side jaw.
Oh, I'm definitely fucking intervening.
Oh, that's my cousin.
Yes.
That's his friend.
My cousin.
That's
my
friend. Okay, that's well, I'm friend. Your friend.
You don't give a
that's
fuck?
My friend.
I'm your friend too. Hey.
I'll be like, this. If I want my little joy and I see her, yeah, this my homie right here.
No, I'll be like, hey, what's up? All that.
This shot.
Oh, Lord.
We're friends, right? We're all
pull
friends.
A chair. Get some hookah.
Right?
I just met you today.
Where the hookah at, right? Like,
you try to hit the hook shot.
Oh, Lord.
Damn, that's wild. Thank God that never happened to be. Yes.
They don't get a little friendship, but he got to go out of town with it.
Yeah. Please go out of town.
Anyway, y'all.
Anyway, I got to deal with that.
This is the Goodfellas podcast, along with Defeat the Norm podcast.
We got Lady GLO on the mic.
Shot.
Okay.
Jeez. This is Jigga.
Rob. Say your name.
Stay the fuck out of here. Anyway, hold on. Wait.
Do your promo. Go ahead.
Next week.
Oh, yeah. All right. Yo, hold on. Listen. So next week, August 24th, is next Saturday. Cup Life, Tip Drill, secret location. You know what I'm saying? Cop your ticket through Eventbrite. Yeah, you coming because I'm shelling that shit. I swear to God. DJ What Up NYC, Showcase, Poppy Jugs, Slim Goodies. There's a bunch of different teams collaborating. Shouts to the Weekend Crew. Shouts to Civ Sav. Shouts to literally anybody and everybody that's participating in this pool party. No, I'm dead ass, yo, because this shit is really about to be a movie. This shit's really about to be crazy, yo. I'm excited. This weekend about to be crazy. And this
Oh, wait, let me just do one thing.
Do your thing, Lady GLO. Talk to me.
All right, cool. All right, so, you know, for the Defeat the Norm podcast, we're having, you know, 100 episode podcast episode. So we're going to throw, you know, a party.
100 episodes.
Yes. Yeah. It's been like almost 2 years now. We're going to throw a party. Open bar. It's going to be in either, I think, was it in Newark or Elizabeth, whatever it's going to be. But, you know, open bar. It's going to be lit, you know.
That's what it is.
So, September 15th.
Okay.
So just be on the lookout for the flyers.
Okay, yeah, I'm about to say we might be there.
Goodfellas will be the building.
Definitely won't be in
there. Y'all need a DJ.
Okay. DJ, you got the best one in the world right there.
You got that?
But yeah, that.
So you know it's a celebration.
Defeat the Norm podcast.
Marv, how the fuck did you cut your beard?
Marv threw me off too with that shit. Yeah, that shit threw me off. Oh yeah, and shouts out to Hugo and the whole We Are That podcast. They should drop tomorrow. A little collab episode. So yeah. I'm loving the whole little group unity shit.
Right.
Yeah, everybody wake up.
Spin the track one up. Episode 26.
Hey.
DJ. We pop out at your party. I'm with the gang. And it's gonna be a robbery. So tuck your chain. I'm a killer girl. I'm sorry. But I can't chain. We ain't aiming for your body. Shots at your brain. We call poverty, man. We ain't have a thing. It's a lot of animosity, but they won't say my name. Them killers ride with me, little nigga, don't get banged. Cause they'll do that job for me while I